poison with dynamite, carrying around heavy canvases, painting nudes. I'll never allow my daughter to do such dirty work, especially for something that won't give you any satisfaction. Do you believe you can make any money covering canvases with awkward colored figures? What's the meaning of this woman with a heart shaped like a lamb? What about this bird flying inside her head?
Dad, you never understood anything about painting.
Perhaps I don't understand anything about painting, but I do understand you. I know you'll end up failing. I know nobody will take you seriously, and you'll fall in love with the first thing. Wow, you're very good, and you'll wind up living under a bridge.
I'm telling you, this is my future. My future. I'm not just going to change my mind.
When the time comes that a serious art critic says your paintings are noteworthy, when important galleries start selling your canvases, then maybe. But until then, I won't allow you to dedicate your life to something that'll drag you down a ditch. And remember, you're underage, and you depend on me. So in the meantime, go to school, study, and concentrate on becoming a nurse like your mother and grandmother.
I don't want to be a nurse. I want to paint.
Oh, nobody's going to take you seriously. You're a little girl. And on top of that, naive and immature.
Well, Dad, you're not changing with the times. Female painters aren't treated like mad women anymore.
Perhaps not like a mad woman, but someone irrelevant.
In a few months, I'll be 18, and then I'll leave the house.
Oh, where do you think you'll go? Without money, without a job? You'll stay here, because you need me as much as I need you.
If you think I'll grow old inside these walls, keeping you company the same way Aunt Marietta did with Granddaddy, well, you're mistaken. Being your nurse, your cook, your crying shoulder. No, I don't want such a hellish fate. And I won't end up like Aunt Marietta.
Your Aunt Marietta was always a bonehead. You'll be the smart one. The cane that will support me in my old age. Your mother left us too soon. You'll be the one taking care of me.
How can a cane be smart, Dad? Believe me, I have to finish a painting before it gets dry. Bye.
Rosa, see you at dinner. 8 o'clock sharp. Don't forget.
You should know by now that I don't cook. If you're hungry, order some pizza from Uncle Giuseppe.
All right. Don't worry about it. Your Uncle Giuseppe always makes some sweet-smelling fried rice balls.
I detest the way that you and Uncle Giuseppe, how you feel about Italy and America. In between, I mean. It's like you're in between one country and the other. In between one culture and the other. Well, in between one language and the other. You two still feel that you're Italian, in a country that gave you a home and work. It's like you're incapable of tearing Italy from your hearts. You know, a country of pizza and jasmine ice cream, a beautiful sea, spun curd mozzarella, and fresh fish. Yeah, what a wonderful country.
Remember, I get off the lean. When you cook those beautiful egg tarts and Parmesan cheese for me, I would hear your heels on the stairs. Then you would knock on my door. Daddy, here are the egg tarts prepared the way you like. With sweet tomato and a streak of mozzarella. My mother had recently left home, and I couldn't get up from bed. You were so sweet, my little girl, so caring. Mornings, a coffee latte, cookies baked with your own hands. In the evening, you would even bring me a glass of wine. A little bit of red wine is good for you, Daddy. Drink some. And you would tuck me in and take my hand. Sometimes you would read something to soothe me. Selena, my little girl, don't go.
finally meet you.
I'm here to see your paintings. Raining, I didn't bring an umbrella. May I take off my wet jacket?
Oh, of course. Do you feel cold? Do you want a towel? I have coffee.
No, thanks. I need to keep moving. I'm in a hurry. I need to be somewhere in 15 minutes.
Oh, I've been waiting for you for months. I'm sorry for insisting, you know, but I need the opinion of an expert. Well, in the articles that you've written about art, they've made you very popular. Even my father knows about you.
I have some experience. You're so young. Still have a long way to go.
Well, I'm almost 21.
I can see you're a little girl. Your family supports me.
No, I'm no longer in touch with my father. I left home and now I live here by myself in Chicago.
How do you manage?
Well, I teach children drawing. I also do some in advertising.
A courageous young woman who supports herself. Way to go. Okay, let's see the paintings.
I honestly think that a positive review from you, oh my gosh, would help me so very much. See, I'm trying to convince a gallery manager to exhibit my work, but he needs another opinion, and yours. Maybe the most important one.
All right, let's see the paintings then.
In addition, I'm trying to convince my father that you're a true expert.
Okay.
So this one's titled The Kiss. I imagine the moon and the sun smelling each other, looking for each other.
Okay.
Do you like it?
It's a woman.
This one I titled The Night. It's heaven inhabited by sorrow, and the stars are like the moon. But you're not saying anything. This one over here. I titled this one Maternity. As you can see, the mother holds her future life in her womb, and we can glimpse the child who just. Mr. Fink, your silence makes me uncomfortable. Say something. Your opinion, please.
We shouldn't rush. Let's move on.
This one's titled Intellectual Disorder. By using these piercing colors here, I'm referring to a mental state in which the viewer lives.
Don't worry so much about explaining it, but the painting must speak for itself.
I'm sorry. You're right. Do you want to know the titles? Last time I called. Titled Tenderness. Mr. Fink, I'm nervous now. Could you please give me your opinion?
I'll write you a letter. No, I must leave. I'm in a hurry. Your naivete, it moved me, but also troubled me.
What do you mean by naivete?
You know, you have a beautiful mouth. Anyone would love to kiss it.
Excuse me. What does this have to do with my mouth?
You're provocative, you know. Your candor is provocative. Your young body is provocative. But I'm a serious man. I won't give in to it. I'll write to you.
Couldn't you tell me something now? Your opinion. Even if it's negative, I could use some criticism. I'm young. I can improve.
Amateur. Remember these words. Amateur paintings created by two angelic hands and an intense, alive, and sweet body that deserves much attention. Goodbye. Good luck.
amateur. Amateur. Do you know what that means?
No.
I will go.
Well, come inside. I'll get you some tea. You're all wet. Is it still raining out? Nicola, say if he were to see how much I drink, and how much I think, by myself, always by myself, a rose and a knife, or a rose and a shoe, but without a heel, or a rose and a spider on a porcelain plate. What's with the roses? They're important, Dad. Weren't you the one who wanted to call me Rosa? Nothing so that your shadow would come.
you stare like that, twiddling your thumbs and looking at the wall.
Oh, but I see beautiful holes in the wall. They're black holes in which a stalling whisper passes.
Don't try me, Rose. You're raving.
I'm not raving, Dad. I'm just thinking.
You look like a son. You did the right thing by coming back. After 2 years of hunger, disappointment, rejection from gallery managers and critics, you've given up. You lost the opportunity to teach private lessons. The only thing you brought back is your canvases rolled up inside some shoes. I'm happy you returned my De Rosa, but my heart is broken.